Hello, Christ the King artists. Welcome to art. I want to take a minute to thank you for your support and prayers while I'm staying at home at this time. Let's get started with a prayer. Center yourselves, quiet your body and your mind, and remember we're in God's presence. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Loving Father, thank you that you are my creator. You know me better than anyone else. Help me to use the mind you have given me to learn, study, and create effectively. May I embrace expectations and learn with humility and grace. Let me live a life of integrity in all I do. May I grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Great. Have a seat. Get out your sketchbooks and a pencil. Today, we're going to take 3 minutes with our sketch prompt, and we're going to think of as many symbols of Halloween that we can, and we're going to sketch those down in the 3 minutes that I'm giving you. And teachers, please feel free to pause this video anytime if your students need more time. Okay, here we go. 3 minutes on the clock. Ready, start. Looks like we have about 2 more minutes. If you don't know what to do, I'm going to show you what I'm doing and maybe it'll give you some inspiration. I'm thinking of a ghost. And a moon and a pumpkin. Maybe you can think of some of those things. You have about 1.5 minutes left. See what more you can create. One more minute. All right, just a few more seconds here. Wrap up what you've been creating. Okay, time is up, pencils down. And I'm going to give you 30 seconds to share with your neighbor what you've created in your sketchbook of Halloween items. Ready, set, go. Okay, artist, start wrapping up your thoughts in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Close your sketchbooks, please. And bring your attention to the board. Have you ever heard of Day of the Dead? Do you know what the word is in Spanish? Día de Muertos, or Day of the Dead. It's a special holiday. Raise your hand or give me a thumbs up if you've ever seen this movie. You might be familiar with it. This was a cartoon that Disney, Pixar, had in the theaters years ago called Coco. And it was about a boy and his family around the time of Day of the Dead, which is a Mexican multi-day holiday that involves family and friends gathering to pray for and remember friends and family members who have died. It is a day of celebration. Now, here's another question. Do you know what the masks worn are called? So we're gonna come over here to this next slide and we're going to take a look at our word of the day. Sugar skull or calavera. Give me a thumbs up if you've ever heard of this term. The tradition of sugar skulls is for families to decorate their loved ones' altars or ofrendas with. These masks are traditionally handmade with sugar. That's why they're called sugar skulls. Now, today, some people make paper masks or paint their faces like the woman shown here in the picture. So let's take a minute and take a look at what we notice about sugar skulls. Here on the screen, you'll see a couple of pictures. Take a second to look at it and think about what you notice. Now, I'm going to give you 30 more seconds and you're going to turn to a different neighbor and you're going to tell that neighbor what you notice about sugar skulls. Ready? Go. Okay, come on back in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well, hopefully you said a couple of these things. They're colorful. You'll notice that there's some colors around the eyes and the mouth. Also, hopefully you notice that there's shapes. There's organic shapes. There's geometric shapes, there's a combination of shapes. And another thing is they're abstract. It is not a realistic skull. All right, so now we're gonna have some Halloween fun. It is almost Halloween and I love to celebrate, so let's stand up and let's have a quick dance break. Make sure you're in your own space. And you are not dancing near anybody. Stand right behind your desk. Okay, here we go. Screams, that's me. Job. Go ahead and find your seats. Quiet yourself down. Excellent Halloween dance break. Okay, now it's time to create. I'm so excited to make sugar skulls. You're going to make your very own sugar skull or calavera. So let's get started. In order to do this, you are going to need the handout from your teacher. Boys, yours will look like this one, the one on the right. And girls, yours will look like this one, the one on the left. You'll notice that the face is blank. So you're going to need a pencil to start. So let's get started. Follow along with these steps. Step one, add your own shapes around the eyes, mouth, forehead, and cheeks. Again, we're gonna start with pencil. And really, there's no right or wrong here. Play around with fun shapes and lines. Here we go, let's get started. Also, if you are unsure of where to go ahead and take a peek at the examples up on the screen, and you can absolutely use that for inspiration. Take your time, as always, and think about craftsmanship. If you're unsure where to begin, start with a line or maybe your favorite shape. Notice that around the eyes and the nose, you can take little tiny organic shapes and you can add them and repeat them. Or you can think of a pattern, just like our word of the day yesterday. You'll notice that on these, there's also a little bit of symmetry, kind of like a butterfly has symmetry. It's not required, but you absolutely can add some symmetry to yours. Hopefully you're having a fun time adding the details. And you're nearing the end. Make sure that you do not add anything inside the eyes or the nose. If you've already done that, that's okay. Also play around with adding shapes in within shapes. Great job, artists. I hope that you had fun creating your own sugar skull with pencil. Let's move on to the next step. If you're not ready, that's okay. Just listen and remember the steps. They'll be up on the screen. Step two, you're going to take a black marker or a Sharpie and you're going to trace the lines that you added and created. Again, take your time and make sure you're not rushing. Craftsmanship, craftsmanship, craftsmanship. I always want you to be thinking of craftsmanship, taking your time and creating something beautiful. And it's okay if you mess up with the marker because you can always erase the pencil that's still showing through. So all is not lost if you make a mistake. Remember, in art, mistakes can be really great because they lead us to new discoveries. Hopefully your blank sugar skull is transforming to something beautiful with the use of element, of line, and shape. A few more minutes. Take your time and remember that this is independent work. There's no need to discuss what you're doing with your neighbors, but you will get the chance to do that when the time is right. Okay, so hopefully by now your mask is looking a little something like this with some fun details using the element of line and shape. And I think we're just about ready to move on to the next step, step three. Now you're going to add color. Use the element of color to add color to the shapes and lines that you created. Think of using purple, orange, green, yellow, blue. Oops, I have orange on there twice. I think orange is a Halloween color, so it would be really good for you to use it. I'm going to be using my favorite medium, crayons. I'm going to pull out those colors. I only have one orange, so I'm only going to pull out one orange. Purple, green, blue, and yellow. I'm going to use these colors. And again, as you add color, make sure you're using craftsmanship. There's really no right or wrong here. So take your time. And as always, use craftsmanship. If you notice there's, before you add color, or as you're adding color, if you notice that there's some pencil lingering, you can take your eraser and just go ahead and gently erase and get rid of any of those pencil lines. Also, girls, since you have flowers that were pre-existing on your skull mask printout, you can color the flowers up top as well. Now, when you're adding color, it takes a little bit of time and effort because there's lots of little details. Take your time, don't rush, stay inside the lines. When you're done coloring, you're going to get scissors and you're going to cut out your sugar skull. And you get to take it home. And when you get home, you can ask your grown-up for a ribbon and you can cut little tiny holes on the sides. Make sure that you cut out the eyes. And you can wear it as a mask. Hope you enjoyed today's lesson about sugar skulls. If you have leftover time, if you finish and others are working, ask for another calavera to color. Your teacher should have that printed. You're also, if you don't have time and you want to take it home, you're welcome to take it home and spend some time coloring it. And remember, God loves you, and so do I. Happy creating, artists.